of upcoming sites on our video tour. The first stop, Elkton, Virginia, in the Shenandoah Valley, where a viewer suggested we look up an unorthodox character named Hobby Robinson, the only Jewish man in a small southern town. But ours will be a story of pride, not prejudice, for Hobby has lived here all his life and has spent most of it photographing and documenting the people and places he loves with a passion.
This is a picture of my crew when we were 12 years old, the kids I pulled around. This is me eating, of course, naturally. You can tell that by the size. And this young gentleman with his feet, toes curled over the edge of the rock is Carl Chick Munger right here, one of my bullhead buddies.
It began, as some of our story ideas do, with a phone call from a viewer. She said we ought to do a story on a fellow named Hobby Robinson, a storekeeper in the little town of Elkton, Virginia, not to be confused with the Maryland community by the same name that is famous as the marriage capital. Elkton, Virginia is a little short on claims to fame, unless, as the caller did, you include Hobby Robinson, the only Jewish man who lives there. He wears the Star of David on his clothing like a badge of honor. Well, you could imagine how that might go over in a sleepy southern town. Actually, unless you know the town and Hobby, you can't imagine. This could be any small town USA, where one stop sign on Main Street controls the traffic, and a passing freight is just about the only thing that causes a backup. Nestled among the mountains that form the Shenandoah Valley, Elkton, Virginia is a place where time may not be standing still, but it's moving mighty slow.
Come on back. What size pants? Do you know, Mr. Lane? 33 in the waist. All right, come on back.
For Hobby Robinson, proprietor of what passes for a department store in Elkton, this community of 1,500 souls is more than a place of business, more than his place of birth. It is the subject of an incurable fascination with the people, the style of life in a small town. Where some might see the boredom of a backwater existence, Hobby has seen the adventure of a lifetime.
Right, exactly. Thank you a whole lot. I must admit, as a child growing up, I was forward. I had to be. I was so curious about life. I was so curious about things that went on around me. But everything I saw was like out of a storybook. I was quite a reader when I was a child. Grimm's fairy tales, all of them. But to me, living in a town like this, small town, that was a fairy tale. Everything was so wonderful. I enjoyed everything that happened. Everybody that come in our store. I was fortunate in being in a place that I met so many people. And I could pick out the characters, the ones that were interesting, the ones that wasn't interesting. The building next door is where I was born 69 years ago, in the upper room here. And it's the building that was a grocery store, and I bought my first penny candies there.
As Hobby tells it, his father was a shoe salesman from Baltimore who arrived in town looking for a bride, married the shopkeeper's daughter, and became a member of the only Jewish family in Elkton. That made little Hobby Robinson and his sisters the only Jewish kids for miles around.
As a child, not having a synagogue close to Elkton, I didn't get a chance to really study my own religion, Jewish religion. But my little buddies, every Sunday morning, would gather up and go up on the hill right here to the Methodist church. Well, I wanted to go with them. My father said, well, go ahead, says, you're not going to understand your own language till you learn the other man's language for comparison. So I would go and learn, and he'd come back and he'd tell me what there was in Jewish.
From his father, his grandfather, and the occasional Jewish traveling salesman, Hobby learned about pride and prejudice. The lessons have never worn off.
This is my symbol, and I loved it, wearing it. I wear it everywhere. I've got it on my work clothes, work jackets. And then another point was, one day, a young salesman pulled up in front of my store. And I stood and I watched him get out of the car. And I recognized he was Jewish. And he took off a ring. and put it in his pocket. I opened the door. I says, you don't have to do that. And I had to start David on. He said, well, says, I never know when I come to these small towns how they will accept me as being Jewish. I said, don't worry how they accept you. Don't hide it. Be proud of it.
If you think Hobby Robinson is proud of his religion, it is nothing compared to how he feels about his town and its people.
You went up to the restaurant this morning?
No, I don't go up
there. You don't go up there anymore, do you? Seems to me that these people are a very passionate people. They can love with a passion and they can hate with a passion. But it's something about them that they always looked on the right side. Well, we had a few guys that were off the regular beat. But most of them are real, just nice, honest people. Now, even our Ku Klux Klan, now they were pussycats. Believe you me, a little buddy of mine, we knew where they met to put on their white uniforms, shrouds, and we would follow them, and when they'd come out carrying a cross, we'd lay down and shoot them with BB guns, because they made a beautiful target on them on a moonlight night, those white sheets shining with our BB guns. And one of them was my buddy's brother. Well, another time, they never bothered the blacks. They never bothered us Jews. But they would, house that maybe had, we'd call it a house of ill repute. Well, I remember distinctly, one night we were watching them put up a cross and burn it in front of this house of ill repute. And the first two men out the back door were members of the Klan that didn't know they was having a meeting. So, pull your head up. That a boy, now you're talking. You got it right on the nose. Gotcha.
In his youth, Hobby went to school in Florida, learned about photography, and for as long as most hereabouts can remember, he's been taking pictures of everything and everybody.
Look mad then. Frown a little bit. That's all right. I don't mind. Let's get another one, huh? Most people look at my cameras and wonder why they're not in a museum or in an antique store. They don't realize that I still use these cameras. That's why. To me, they're not old. This camera here was probably made about 1945, 46. That's, to me, a modern camera.
His store is a gallery filled with the faces of Elkton then and now. In recent years, he has published half a dozen books featuring the people and the places that have meant so much to him.
Now approaching the old freight station, and these steps were the steps that I sat on from the time I was 4 years old up to date, and I still do. When we approached this a few minutes ago, for just a flash, I saw the ghost in my mind of the kids and the people that I used to sit here with. To think about the characters of my life that have made this life so interesting. And the number one character was a man by the name of Herman Zut Zeddy. To me, a cowboy. I've never known him to drive, never knew him to drive a car. Ride a horse like a dream. He should have been born in the wagon, to go on with the wagons west. There's a story that's really true that he rode his horse, whose name was Buck, into the drugstore here and demanded a Coca-Cola for him. And the druggist took out a big cup of Coca-Cola and gave it to the horse to drink. In 1969, I came out with a book on the people, the characters of this town. And in 1972, I came out with another book. The first one was all men who are deceased, and the second one was ladies of the town that I knew as a child and I loved. Well, the town fathers, they decided they wanted to do something for me. So one of the councilmen asked me what I'd like to have them do. Well, at that time, I was studying the life of Ben Yehuda in Israel, the man that brought the Hebrew language back to Israel. And I asked him if he would name it Ben Yehuda Road for me. And he said he'd be delighted. So it was a unanimous vote. Everything went fine. And from then on, it was Ben Yehuda Road.
The philosophy of life, according to Hobby Robinson. To forget yesterday, he says, is to lose tomorrow. With each photograph, He guarantees that a little piece of Elkton's yesterday will be remembered. As for his tomorrow,
I'm going to sell out of this business as it is. I'm going to open me up a little book and magazine shop with my own little dark room in the back of it. And that's the way I want to live until I want to die there. That's it. I'm happy. If I go tomorrow, I'm happy. Every day is a bonus to me. Every day I live is a bonus. I wake up in the mornings, I pinch myself on the butt, and I say, go get them, you're still here.